Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can go from a decomposition tree to the details of that decomposition tree. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, we're doing a live stream recently and someone said, hey, can you enable drill through on a decomp tree? And I emphatically said, without a doubt, no. And we kept talking. And then Wyn Hopkins, what's up, Wyn? Wyn was like, yes, you can. And I tinkered a bit and I was like, oh my God, I didn't know you could do this. So I decided, let's do a video on it to show everybody how it works. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. With a decomposition tree, it lets you drill across several dimension attributes. And there's even some AI built into it. And so you see I've set my decomp tree up here and I'm gonna analyze total sales amount. And I want to analyze it by product name, subcategory. And so what I can do is I can click the plus key and I can use the AI that's built in, or I can choose an attribute. So I can say, all right, I wanna go down to the country, then I wanna go down the category, and I wanna go down the subcategory, and then product name. It'll aggregate down just like that. The challenge is maybe I want to see the customers that make up the details for this particular path of the decomp tree. How would you do that? Well, it's actually pretty simple. If I go over to my details page and don't judge the reports, and I just need to choose one of the explain by columns from my decomp tree. I'm just going to start with sales territory country. So I'm going to go over to details. I'm going to choose sales territory country, drop it here, and notice I have keep filters off. So I'm going to head back to my dimp. Let's rename that decomp. Head back over to my decomp tree and I'm going to hover right here and it says right click the drill. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose drill through and I'm going to go to details and it passed the country. So it's United States. So I have the different regions in the United States. And when I did that, I was thinking, well, do I need to add every column from my explain by to the drill through section in my details table? And I was like, boy, that's a lot. But I thought about something. I say, what if I just toggle keep filters on? So let me show you. So I'm gonna go back to the details page and I'm gonna go ahead and turn on keep filters. So I'll turn on keep filters and I'm gonna go back to my decomp. So you can see I have a slicer. And so when you turn on keep filters, it'll pass the values from the slicer in the filter pane. I'm just gonna clear that out for now. And I'm gonna go all the way to the end to the product name and I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna choose drill through the details. Look at this. It picks up the entire path. So subcategory was helmets, category was accessories, country was United States. So it picks up the entire path. What if I go back up the decomp tree a little bit to category? So I'm going to go to bikes. It should just pass my United States and bikes there. So I'm going to right click here, drill through and choose details. Boom. It actually follows the filter path. Whatever level of that decomp tree you are, that's the filter that it passes. But I'm still thinking, wait a minute. So I still need to add one of those columns. What if I don't include that column in the decomp tree? Let's see what happens. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to delete sales territory country. Will the drill still be enabled? So I'm going to right click here. No drill. If my report consumer expects the drill, but they don't include that particular column in the analyzing of my decomp tree, then there's no drill. So how do you get around that? Well, it's easy. You use the measure, the base. You use what you're analyzing as the drill item, and then it should just work. Let me show you. So I'm gonna head over to my details page. I'm gonna turn off keep filters. Now watch what happens when I add the measure to my drill through fields here. It automatically turns on keep filters. You can't turn it off. So what that means is it's gonna pass all the filters. It's gonna pass any slicer filters, any filters I have on my filter pane, it's gonna pass all of those out and about. And so let's choose black, right click on bikes, and there you go. There's my drill to details. And it only passes bikes and black. If I go back to the decomp page and I go up one section to helmets, does it recognize that I'm not all the way at the end on product name? Of course it does. And it's reflected in the data. You can see 727,000. If I go there, it's 727,000. It works pretty easily and pretty seamlessly. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments? Have you done any of this stuff with decomps? Did you know you could drill to the details from your decomp tree? I didn't, and I learned something new. And it's great to learn something new. All right, so you guys know what we like to do. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.